Hello guys, and welcome back to this channel. So in this video, I want to give you my 6 tips for starting keto. I'm basically a keto enthusiast and I've been on the ketogenic diet for over 3 months now. I am in the best weight that I've been since 7 years, since I have been 22. I used to look like this. I actually lost the most weight with calorie counting, not with the ketogenic diet, but the calorie counting diet, I was on a high carb, low fat diet and it was just not sustainable. And the moment I went off the calorie counting, I rapidly regained 10 kilos or 22 pounds and I was looking for something that is sustainable. And that's when I found the ketogenic diet, and the ketogenic diet is the most amazing diet that I've ever been on. And I feel like it's the holy grail of diets. So I just wanna spread the word about it. And if you wanna try it out, I really advise you to keep to it, go through the adaptation phase, you will see the benefits and you will not regret that you have done it. So if you're new to this channel, it would be awesome if you would subscribe so that you stay tuned with other keto videos that are coming out. But for now, let's go on to the tips for starting keto. So what is keto? So the ketogenic lifestyle or the ketogenic diet is a diet where you eat very high fat, very low carbs, and moderate protein. There is a very specific way that makes it easy to start it. This is how I started it, and this is what I recommend. There could be other ways that work. Basically, what this diet does is that it switches your body from burning glucose or sugar for energy, and it switches your body into utilizing fat. And the byproduct of burning fat is ketones, and the ketones is basically something that transports oxygen into your body and your brain, and it's basically a lot better source of fuel for your body than sugar. And when you burn fat for energy and not sugar, that state is called ketosis. And in ketosis, you actually will experience lack of hunger, a sharper focus, a sharper brain, and that's simply because ketones can carry more oxygen per unit of ketone than glucose can, so your brain actually gets more oxygen, so you're more alert. And there is a lot of other health benefits from doing keto, which I'm not going to go into. So here's the deal. When you start keto, like, your body most probably has been running on sugar for most of your life, so obviously it's not going to come easy and you're going to have some side effects, which is called the keto flu. And this is obviously because when you restrict your carbs and your body has no more carbs to burn, it doesn't yet know what to do with the fat that is in your body, and it doesn't yet know how to effectively burn this. So these side effects that you can experience is called the keto flu. And this just happens, you just have to push through it. You can very much minimize the keto flu by making sure you take enough salt and you take enough potassium and you refill your body on electrolytes. But after about a week or 2 weeks, it can maybe take 3 weeks, you start being fat adapted. And that means that your body will start getting efficient on burning your fat for fuel, and this will also happen on a gradient. For me, it took 3 months to fully go into fat adaption and not have carb cravings anymore, for my hunger to be very minimal, and the diet just to become a breeze. So just know this when you're starting. So now that I talk so much about the keto diet, let's talk about my 6 tips for starting keto if you're new. So the number one tip is that when you start, that you don't first do this for fat loss. Because this might sound very weird for you, like, what do you mean? I'm doing keto to lose weight and now you're telling me to not do it for fat loss? But let me explain. Basically, your body has to go through this adaptation to fat, and this can be very stressy for the body and very stressy for you. So to make it easier on you, what I recommend is that in the beginning, you just eat whenever you feel like eating. Whenever you feel hungry, you just eat, but within the ketogenic diet. So the ketogenic diet is 70-80% of your calories must come from fat, 20-25% of your calories must come from protein, and 5% of your calories should actually come from carbs. Like, to be low carb, it's also awesome if you try to stay below 30 grams of carbs. So this diet as you can see from the 30 grams of carbs, is a super low carb diet. So when you're in this adaptation phase, until your hunger goes away, which could take a week, could take 2 weeks, don't worry, you're not going to gain weight, but you're not going to lose either. When you're beginning on the keto diet, what I would do is I would just keep the ketogenic diet, but don't worry about counting calories, don't worry about how much you're eating. Whenever you're hungry, just eat and you'll be just fine. So this was my number one tip. My number two tip is, while you're adjusting to the keto diet, make sure you study a lot about the diet. The keto diet is a lifestyle change and there is a lot to it. And as any diet, if you do it wrong, it can have some serious side effects. You can get kidney stones, and don't worry, it's actually quite hard to get it. But still, I just want to illustrate that there is a lot to learn about this diet and it's a new thing. So watch a lot of YouTube videos, read lots of books, and yeah, watch a lot of this channel. I mean, my purpose is to help you be on the keto diet and make it as simple as possible. So then my number three advice, or number three tip for starting on keto, is that you keep track of your macros. And this can be a pain in the ass, but the reason why it's really worth it is because if you keep up with this for about 3 to 4 months, you will really learn which foods have how much fat and how much carbs, and sometimes it can be very surprising. And after 3 months, you can completely stop with this because you will just know. But until you know, you really have to, they're so easy to have hidden carbs in foods. So I really advise you to check, for example, cheeses, salamis, like everything when you buy, check and make sure that you read the food labels and you make sure that it's the lowest possible carb. And as I said, after 3 months, you can skip this because you will just know how much of what is in the food and it will be super easy for you to keep the diet. But until you have that point, unfortunately, you have to keep up with counting macros. So my next tip on starting your keto diet is that when your hunger goes away, this could take 1 to 2 to 3 weeks. I hope it will happen fast for you. That's when you start restricting your calories. Again, you will have to count your macros and your calories, but I promise you, once you're adapted to keto, it will be a breeze. You will never have been on a better and easier diet than this. But until you hit this point, don't restrict your calories. But when you hit this point, just make sure that you eat about 400 to 500 less calories than what you need to maintain your weight. And basically then you will begin your fat loss and it will be the easiest fat loss that you have ever experienced, I promise you. If you want to make it even easier, you can also start intermittent fasting, which means that you restrict how many times a day that you eat. So you eat on the ketogenic diet, but let's say you only have a lunch and a dinner, and then your body will basically be even more efficient at burning your own fat and you will very, very easily lose weight. So now my next tip is that you watch a lot of videos about keto recipes and you buy a lot of keto cookbooks, and you can check out our website. We have a lot of keto recipes there and a lot of keto tips and a lot of keto accessories, because if your whole lifestyle has been eating carbs, most probably when you go on keto, you will not know any food and you will not have any idea what to eat. And then, for example, what I did is I watched quite some keto videos and then I'm like, okay, good. I can eat cheeses, salami, eggs and bacon and salads, and it's awesome. And after I've been on this for 3 months, I suddenly noticed that I'm about to throw up from the food because it became very, very repetitive. And actually, keto can be an extremely, extremely boring diet. So you have to make sure that you keep up your excitement about keto and you don't get to this point. Again, it's sort of like study about keto, but you look up a lot of recipes. You basically make sure that you all the time have a variety of food. And that way, actually, it's also the next tip, is that in that way, you keep in all your nutritions and you give your body what it needs, but you do it in a very smart way. So actually lose a lot of weight, because that's why we eat, folks. The reason why we eat is to get the nutrients and energy to your body that you need. So it's actually very, very important that you do keto in a way that your body has all the nutrients and everything that it needs. So If you keep all these tips, you will have a very easy transition into the ketogenic diet, and you will have a very easy time to lose weight if that's your goal. I don't think ketogenic diet is the best for everyone, but I strongly recommend that you try it and see if it works for you. I really hope that it does, and I really hope that this video gave you some valuable information. I want to thank you for watching. Make sure that in the comments you let me know if I missed out anything or if you have any questions. I'll be very happy to answer you. Stay on keto. Until the next time I see you. Ciao, ciao.